Hi everyone, Chris here, and today I wanted to go just a wee bit deeper into Bloom's taxonomy. And today I wanted to focus on the cognitive domain, which is the knowledge domain, and when you're trying to teach knowledge, as opposed to the affective domain when you're trying to instill values or work on someone's emotions, or the psychomotor domain when you're trying to teach a skill, whether that skill is throwing a football or getting the white balance right in Adobe Photoshop. So in the cognitive domain, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 levels. And these levels were, and the whole concept was pretty much outlined by Bloom and his team in 1956. But in 2001, Anderson and his team ended up doing revision. So that's why you'll hear about Bloom's revised taxonomy. And there are all kinds of fun ones now. Bloom's digital taxonomy, Bloom's iPad taxonomy, and everybody and their mom seems to want to like jump onto this bandwagon. But really, it really does come down to the Anderson revised taxonomy. And there were two important two of the most important things that Anderson and his team did was they changed the names of all of the different levels of learning from nouns to verbs. So not rather than what you got, it's what you did. And then they also adjusted to the changing times and sort of swapped the two. So we're not going to deal too much with the original Blooms. We're going to just stick with the revised version because that's probably what you're going to see. The other thing you're going to hear a lot is to, especially if you're in K-12 or higher ed, it's focus on the higher learning skills. And, that's the top three. So when we talk about the Bloom's taxonomy, I'm going to start at the top and work my way down. And, you know, it's kind of, most people go the other way. So at the top of the taxonomy, we have create. So having your students create something. And that's great. You know, they could create a film, they could create a brand new way of doing something, they could 3D print something and create. But what are they creating? And so in order to create something, you have to know how to evaluate what's going on with the topic you're doing. So the one underneath that is evaluate. And if you're going to evaluate something, then you're going to need to know how to analyze it because it's tough to evaluate something if you can't break it down. So we have analyze. And then as we sort of break this down further, if you're going to analyze something, you need to know how to apply what it is you're analyzing because then you're just sort of talking about stuff you don't know. So we have apply. And then if you're going to apply a skill or apply knowledge, you kind of have to understand it. And then if you're going to understand something, well, you kind of have to remember it. So the last one is remember. So that's the Bloom's taxonomy of learning for the cognitive domain. And there are a couple of things that are really important in the way that this is laid out that kind of get lost because a lot of people look at this and then, they have their verb guide. I love verb guides, by the way. So they'll have their verb guide for each of the levels, a bunch of action verbs. These are all action verbs that are at each level. And then the boss says, focus on the higher learning skills. So they go straight to create. And they write their learning objectives as learners will create something. And you can't really do that unless you've built the foundation on each of these different levels. Another way to draw this might be as a skyscraper. And oh, yes, you know, the goal is to get to the 6th floor. Well, what you walk in on the ground level and you have to move up each level and build before you get to the top. And the other thing that's important about this visual in particular is it's kind of like the food pyramid where you're supposed to have a whole lot of this and a very little bit of this in your diet. And that's kind of how it goes when you're organizing on building a curriculum. You're going to want some really great examples of analyzing, evaluating, creating things. But in order to make those work, you're going to need a whole lot of remembering the details, understanding what it is you're talking about, and applying that knowledge in real ways. And once you have each of these as they build, then you end up being able to create new knowledge or create products that sort of are new. And that's kind of where it comes from. So when you're building your curriculum or you're building your lesson, if you're focusing on the higher learning skills, and maybe you're only going to evaluate or analyze, or maybe you're not even going all the way there, you just want your learners to apply their knowledge. Well, in order for them to apply, they need to understand and they need to remember. So you always have to build in the levels below, whether you explicitly put them in your learning objectives or you embed them in the lesson. Always make sure that you have a chance to check for students remembering what you're talking about, understand, and then to the different level that you're actually aiming for in your particular lesson. So that's kind of my take on Bloom's taxonomy in the cognitive domain. Kind of rambling there, but yeah, a good verb guide will help you build that. There's a ton of those online. And yeah, I really do have one on my desktop as my wallpaper. So tomorrow, I don't know which one I'm going to do, but I'll either do the psychomotor or the affective domain, and we'll have fun tomorrow. So I'll see you then.